What's up, YouTube fam? So today we're going to be talking about a film entitled Test Pattern. And this movie is available now for purchase at testpatternmovie.com. This movie has screened over tons of film festivals, even going back into August of 2019 up until recent this month. And I would assume it probably was going to hit more film festivals, but based on the state of the pandemic, you know, that's all in flux. But you can get more information about that at testpatternmovie.com. But test pattern. So let's talk about the definition of what a test pattern is. So a test pattern is a fixed picture broadcast by a television station to assist viewers in adjusting their receivers. Like, literally, let that sink in just for a second. But this part psychological horror, part realist drama, Test Pattern is a set against the backdrop of our national discussion about the unjust health system, the MeToo movement, and the race relations in America. And then the theme of this movie, Rethink What You Think You Know, is so challenging, yet an appropriate model here. But this film, what it's about is it follows an interracial couple in Austin, Texas, Evan and Rynisha, who are complete opposite. Evan is Caucasian. He's a low-key, awkward tattoo artist. And Rynisha is an African-American who is confident buttoned-up PR executive. And they're absolutely a beautiful couple. And quite frankly, they're just indissolvable. Like, they're just made for each other. But everything changed as she becomes a victim of sexual assault and the relationship is truly put to a test. I mean, not only is it a test between them to do the right thing and be there for one another, but the biased medical system and criminal system that surrounds this. So this film is by the director, Shatara Michelle Ford, which I believe this is her first feature-length film, but she draws a nuanced portrait of consent within the patriarchal society, trusting the audience, us, to color in their own perception and belief, and not to mention the effects of the systematic factors and social conditioning women face when navigating sex within American patriarchy. So that's really deep and such an amazing cause and for someone to get behind. And like I said, to really go in here and draw your own conclusion and analysis and dare to be challenged, shall I say. But let me go over my thoughts about this film really quick. So I can't stress enough, they're such a beautiful couple together. An amazing chemistry between the two of them. It was just so easy to really get behind them. I mean, quite frankly, before the title screen, you got so much character development for viewers. I feel like you just automatically invest in them really, really quick. I was rooting for them. I was rooting for love for them the entire time. And even where it seemed like it wanted to blink tragedy, I was just rooting for love the entire time, because that's just how much I was invested into the two leads here. They did a phenomenal job. I'll talk about them more in a second. I really, really am a fan of neon colors, and I love scenes that use that abstract. The pink and the blue, and like I just love it. When I shoot photography, that is just my weakness. I love it. Matter of fact, there was a bunch of like still sets that I just really loved the shots that they done. It was amazing. But like I said, it was truly easy to get behind the characters. Like, Evan was my hero, who was played by Will Brill. He did an amazing job. This guy was just humble the entire film, and when he had to turn up, he turned up in the film, and I just could get behind that. He was my hero for sure. I felt like there was the moral compass behind the character is someone I can get behind, because he really stood by his girl no matter what, even in the eye of adversity, even times where, you know, the typical male probably would have took another route, and how they did it, he stood by her the entire time. I really loved it. And what an amazing and emotional performance by Brittany S. Hall. Rynisha, the character, you couldn't help but to sympathize with her the entire time. From, you know, the moment when they fell in love, the moment when she got a new job, the moment, you know, where, you know, the sexual assault happened and the effects afterwards, you just totally are invested with her, and you just root for her the entire time. And the emotions that she pulled on screen, it's so easy to dive into it. And much like myself, just be consumed by it so much that even at the conclusion of the film, I was just in a pool of emotion because it was just a fantastic job in that role. I got to mention, too, I love the classical elements within the score. It really complemented the drama and the stakes that was in each scene. I love scores. But when you are able to apply like a really classical one in this manner, it was just simply amazing. But, you know, this film brought a lot of awareness to sexual assault and actually peer pressure, if you ask me as well, too. But you just see the emotional toll of sexual assault and how truly no one's ever the same. You know, it just brings more awareness to sexual assault and, you know, and how many people voices that are never really heard in the world when you think about it, the victims and how they're left with, you know, no justice and just can be completely powerless. This is all on display in this film. There's particular scenes where they were challenged at the hospitals and given a runarounds because of the inadequate staffing and so on. Then the police officers not giving victims any hope. It just leaves you devastated to know that these type of things exist. But you know, I really like how much the story of the victims of sexual assault, I just really love how, you know, they bring this to the forefront about the victims, and just the effects and toll that it leaves. I mean, it's pretty much PTSD because life does not go on. As you think it would, you don't just wipe your hands and say, okay, it's over. You know, the effects, you've seen the character go from with confidence to kind of lost within her own body at times. And I just thought it was powerful because I feel like, you know, this movie creates a platform for others to want to be able to speak out, to want to help one another. And, you know, for the ones who may not want to have said anything, may be able to dig deep to find confidence or, you know, developable resources that's there for them in order to tell their story, because, you know, this thing happens so much and so often. And, you know, when movies are able to continue to showcase this in a way to educate, it's just truly powerful. And, you know, I thoroughly, thoroughly appreciated it. Again, you can, you know, purchase this film I can't even talk. You can purchase this film at testpatternmovie.com. And not to mention, too, there's also a ton of special engagements packages as well, including Q&As and live discussions with the director. I absolutely recommend this film. It was really well done, beautifully shot, amazing performances. I love the score and a damn good necessary message for right now and years to come. But thankfully, let me know what you think when you watch the film. Come back in the comments, let me know, and I'll catch you guys on the next one.